トン豪華球の術。
Hello and welcome to the start of what is going to be my Splinter Cell full play. Essentially, I'm going to play through all of the Splinter Cell games, starting from the original, at least going up to Chaos Theory, so at least the original trilogy, but we'll see if I continue further than that. So yeah, we're going to kick it off today with Splinter Cell, which is obviously the first game in the series. I'm going to just stick it on normal difficulty. I want to sort of enjoy the game, if that makes sense. I'm trying to work out, actually, if there's a way that I can just do new game. It doesn't look like there is, so I guess what we'll do is we'll just jump in at training and then go through the game from there. So yeah, this is, like I said, the Xbox One version. I'm a huge Splinter Cell fan. I've played them all multiple times. I guess I'll let you listen to this local.
Continued fighting in the Abkhazia and South Ossetia regions has hindered Georgia's hopes of integration into Western institutions. Industry baron Combain Nicolad seized power today in a bloodless coup, installing himself in the presidential palace behind a wall of political and military support. The charismatic billionaire plans on holding elections within a matter of days to affirm his seat of power, and promises a pristine and profitable relationship with America and the West. Bringing high-speed fiber optic connectivity to areas of Eastern Europe that less than a decade past didn't have telephones. The technological leap is due largely to the efforts of rising information industries in the Netherlands, and especially Georgia, where President... The Vice President called his visit to Georgia an honor, and called Georgian President Combain Nicolad a man with his eyes on the future.
Okay, so yeah, this is the original Xbox version played on the Xbox One. It is technically Xbox One X enhanced, but I'm not sure how much they've actually done to it. I'm not sure how much you can do to a game that without remaking it. This is the original. I mean, literally, I've stuck the original Xbox disc in my console and we're playing it on backwards compatibility. I think they maybe added some HDR lighting and I don't know. Other than that, maybe a texture reskin. It doesn't look terrible, you can see it here. It doesn't look awful in terms of like the textures of the wall and stuff. Character models aren't great, but they're not going to improve polygon count or anything like that. It's not a remake, it is the original, as I said. So yeah, I'm just going to jump in with the training.
Sam Fisher.
Because it's been a while.
I can't believe you beat me here. I like to be early. Hello, Colonel. You can use my name, the room's safe.
Lambert. And then we'll just go
good
through.
To see you again. I trust NSA orientation is going well?
Well enough. Everybody's been real coy about what exactly I'm allowed to know.
It's the nature of the agency. We don't let any one person know everything, which means we've all got to work together.
Even though I'll be out there alone.
You'll be transmitting to us in more ways than you can imagine. And we'll be online through your earpiece and OPSAT.
And that's how we're handling training.
Yep. Sorry to make you run the course. I know you've been taking care of yourself.
I haven't been in the field in years.
Sure. But trade graft is something you don't forget. It's like riding a bike.
Or wearing high heels.
Be careful, Fisher. Everything we say is being monitored. You know how nervous the brass is about exercising the fifth freedom.
I'll be good.
Be better than good. Third Echelon is a brand new initiative. The role aggressive intelligence operations will play in NSA's future will depend largely on your performance. I'll see you on the far side of the course.
Motherfucker! Listen, you motherfucker! adequate mask. Everybody get fucked. Let me see you pumping your fist. Tip you up in the back room when you're rocking with this. Come on, keep in your speaker knocking, jumping, banging, bumping, blazing hot, calling all freaks.
Oh, yeah, I remember. Sound time.
The next hallway's the same idea, but for sound. I'll be monitoring a few hidden mics.
So, yeah. In this one, I want it to be real quiet. Obviously, a metal catwalk. It's going to make noise. Stay crouched at all times. And then the chains as well are going to make noise. Just want to avoid them. And then the glass on the floor would make noise. So you want to just lightly touch the thumbstick to creep over them. So noise and light is obviously a big part of this game because it is a stealth simulator.
Have you started yet? Fisher.
Holy Christmas.
Holy Christmas, you're at the end. Phenomenal work. Let's move on.
Gotta be him.
Yep. Sam Fisher, let me introduce you to Vernon Wilkes Jr.
Hello.
Hey, I've heard crazy things about your work.
I hope you don't mind. I told him some of your stories from Kuwait.
We're all friends here.
Right on.
Junior Wilkes is a longtime NSA employee. He'll be your wheels, wings, and weapons. He coordinates transportation and equipment.
Great.
For sure. Man, you must be itching to get back out in the field, huh?
That's all I'm good at.
Man, well, my client's side voice is so cool.
Welcome to the NSA.
I'm sure
I'd love
things are going to come together.
See this game get remade.
Third Echelon is a brand new initiative, and we're going to have a lot to prove.
Right.
The two of you will be Third Echelon's first team on the ground. Be ready for it, and do us proud. Welcome to the NSA.
All right. That's your training mission done. Now we'll dive into the actual game, see if we can get the first mission done for this first part. Because the training's pretty boring, but I wanted to do it because it does kind of tie into the story.
This is going to sting.
Go ahead.
Hold that.
Christ, this is spooky.
What's that?
Grim sticking wires in your head, man.
I just need to sync the encryption signature between his subdermals and Fort Meade.
Don't like that.
I know. It's for after we land. You better hurry up, Grim. We touch down in Georgia in 15.
I'm already done. Lambert? Hey, Irving.
Dude, these cutscenes, though.
Tell her I read her. He reads you.
It looks so bad on, like, an HD.
You ready to get
big
to work?
TV.
I'd feel better if I knew what was going on.
You know what you need to. The CIA lost a mole inside Georgian President Kombane Nikoladze's cabinet. Her name is Alice Madison. They sent in Agent William Robert Blaustein to find her and lost him, too.
Are we working with the CIA's cooperation?
Blaustein is outfitted with subdermals just like yours. That'll be your best lead to find him.
You didn't answer my question.
We'll tell you what you need to know. You're not out there alone, Fisher. Through me, you're attached to a dozen of the best NSA minds we have. There are political complexities with Georgia you'd need a week to understand.
I've just about memorized the speech, Lambert.
Well, start believing it.
This is
third echelon's maiden voyage, and we need it to go smooth as butter. You're about to touch down in Georgia. Get ready.
I wonder if there's subtitles I can put on, that way I can talk over stuff. One thing I will say about these old games, the loading screens are damn fast because there's not that much to load. Right, save checkpoint, yes. So we're done training there, I'm going to go on this empty one and then rotate between the two of them.
Fisher, the sun's down. Time to go to work. Finding Agent Blaustein's our first priority.
Alright, let me see if there's any, dude, I can't even find like a settings menu. Here we go. Sound, video. Alright, there's no subtitle options. Subtitles didn't exist back in the day.
Locate him through a local NSA contact.
I'm on my way.
And stay off the streets. There's a heavy cop presence in this town. We don't have Washington's backing if this turns into an incident. Details on your offset.
Alright, so I think I can't kill police or anything like that. Maybe. Now, as I said earlier, I've played these games a bunch. Do have an awful memory. But I'm gonna just sort of, I'm not gonna try and ghost every mission, because that requires a lot of reloading, because there are a lot of times where like you'll mess up and stuff and you'll reload to not get caught, which I might do a few times depending on the situation where I know I can get around it. But I generally just want to enjoy the game. I want to be able to use Sam's gadgets and stuff, so I don't want to be just relying solely on sneaking through every level without getting seen, because it will also last forever, because it will take me forever. But I will try and do as much sneaky sneak as possible, because that is the point of the game. But I also just want to get involved with Sam's gadgets and abilities other than his sneaking, because that's what we're here for, we're here to enjoy the game. Oh, I remember this band in Bill.
Tell me, Gergenidze is inside there.
Why would I tell you what you already know? You're gonna have to hurry.
Yeah, bloody sucks.
A Dark Star drone.
Checkpoint. Right, so we're rotating between training and police station. I'm definitely gonna save over Presidential Pass at some point.
Sonar
back.
To the warehouse blueprints. Should be guiding you through.
Now, from what I remember, there's a certain route. I don't think it's this.
There's a room directly across the hall. Go there now. Damn, sorry about that. Get back into the hall and go to the stairwell at the far end. Make it fast. We've only got a few seconds.
Alright, on the pipe. This was the pipe that I was thinking of.
Jesus, but that was close. Take a left just ahead.
I keep pressing B to try and
room.
Drop off pipes.
You'll find a stairwell on the opposite corner. Take it to the top floor.
Trying to avoid the fire.
The contact is in this room. Let's hope to God he's still alive.
Gergenidze.
Yeah.
I'm NSA. I'm gonna get you out of here.
Don't bother. I'm as good as dead. They're looking for Blaustein and Madison.
I feel like he's not as good as dead. I could get him out of there.
Blaustein's cabinet. She was onto something big. Blaustein must have figured it out.
How do I find him?
Blaustein's black box. The tracking relay for his subdermals. It's stashed in his safe house just east of Moravia Square.
Lambert. Do we have resources to evac this guy?
I said don't bother.
Like, he's just got a piece of wood on his legs.
She kept saying,
I could get that off and get him out.
I think Nicolas wanted...
Gerganidze checked out.
Leave the corpse for the fire. He has to explain to his family.
You've got a safe exit on the west side of the room. Take it.
Is it this one?
There's too much smoke. Shoot out the skylights.
Oh, come on, bro. I've got to wait for the smoke to clear. Man, I lost health for absolutely no reason there. From what I remember of this game, your health carries over per mission, I think. Not 100% sure, but I think it does. So, like, if you finish a mission with, like, barely any health, you'll start the next mission with barely any health.
That was pretty tight. Still breathing?
Doing my best.
Good. Blaustein's black box is your next objective. He's running standard agency tradecraft. You'll find the box behind a fake bookshelf or wall panel.
Good gringo horn. Because those are my orders. I speak to Vyacheslav Gringo or nobody.
Not nobody.
Gringo, yes, sir. This is Ketevan. We finished searching the American's apartment. There is nothing else there. The 5 more boats, 2 cameras, and some electronics we can't ID. Already on their way to the minister. Of course.
I'm away from to finish his phone call. Then grab him. No. This is as dark as this corner gets. Unfortunately. And I'm not gonna bother shooting off the lights because. Alright, so here's the other dude. I think he's gonna come through. Dude, I totally messed that up.
I've got a man unconscious.
Alright, that's okay. Oh, he's waking him up. Right, it's time to move. If I remember right, it's what I'm looking for. It's behind the painting. Bingo.
Dad, what's the news?
Blaustein's heart stopped beating 43 hours ago.
Any reason the CIA wouldn't know about this?
Damn it.
Nope. Nice of them to share.
The subterminal.
I don't know what that code is. And I also don't know
online 6 hours after he died.
How to get.
Last active position was at the police station a few blocks away. Check your OPSAT.
Right, let me just check something real quick. Code for the door to the balcony is 091772. Okay. I couldn't work out how to get off the key code. 91772. Alright, let's go. Dude. That was a sort of controls issue. That's what I'm blaming that on. So anytime you get that music like that, it means someone's heard something. You haven't been caught, but they're aware that something might be going on. Which is that guy down there, he heard me land on the roof. I'm just gonna wait until he passes underneath me and I go through the door. I almost killed myself there with a dodgy jump. And through the trap door we go.
Fisher, I'm rescinding my street level restriction. We've been monitoring the police radio. These cops are as crooked as I'm.
So now, we're allowed to kill the cops.
Every road is open to you. Do what you've got to do to find those.
It's fair game. Okay, so door's locked. Can I remember how to get my lockpick out? Yes, I can. Thank you. Booyah. Save checkpoint. So one of the more annoying things about this is the fact that I am going to have to keep reloading if I want to ghost areas, which I said I didn't want to do. I kind of do want to do for certain bit. Like, when I know I can do it and I know I can do this bit, then I'm gonna.
Yeah, I think we could set you up with this slab real easy.
So there has been some reloads, for the record.
Nothing? How about drunk and disorderly? Assaulting a police officer? Slandering the badge?
I got caught further up.
Associated with criminals.
And shot. Me. See, I don't mind getting caught, or if I...
Weren't you listening?
If I grab a dude, but, you know.
You want to die tonight? That's free.
No.
You want to sleep tonight?
I'm gonna just gun it.
You 100 Larry.
But please, I don't.
Because I know he's coming down. So you got a guy in the building up there where that window is. And you've also got a guy that'll come down these stairs to the left. Well, actually on the right of the screen, but to the left. And come down this path. So I'm gonna hide here and wait for him. There he is.
Can you send an ambulance?
Once he goes past, I'm gonna try and go for it and get up the stairs.
Roger that, dispatch.
We'll wait. I've just got to be careful of that guy up there in a window, because if he sees me.
Something we can pin on Costa. Good thing.
He'll kick off, right? So he's leaving now. So now's my chance to go. I'm going to just gun it and hope for the best. They've heard the footsteps, but they're not seeing me. Which is, again, fine. Now, if I remember right. Oh, that guy in the window nearly saw me, top left. Watch out for that window guy. There's a little hole here, yeah. Why does this exist? Don't know. But it does. Alright, police station. This one. Okay, so we grab the med kit. Grab the data stick. Grab the med kit. That noise you just heard was a guard coming through the main gate. So that's the main gate outside opening. We got 5929 on the door code. Okay, so we know there's guards out here now. He's there, which is fine. Grab this dude. Alright. Now. This is a dark area. I can put him down up here. I just want to get that guy out of the way, to be honest. I know there's a guy above me. I also know. There's a guy right there. Shit. Now he's got something on him because he's got that pouch on his front. Not sure what it is, but he's got something on him. See if I can get close enough to grab him. The answer was no. Grab his satchel. Right, he had a data stick. See, I'm not going to bother reloading that because it's just annoying. I think he might have had the door code on him as well, I'm not sure. 5929. I've got two medkits on me, so I'm alright on health, and I just cannot be bothered reloading flight. I mean, that's like context sensitive controls on this game. I was close enough to grab him, but it touched him instead, and then he turned around. And like, you can reload and avoid that stuff, but that would be wasting everybody's time. So we move. There's a guard there. It's a good job I hit that body. So, you know, like, again, it's one of them things where I could go in on that guy. See, I'm not sure if I just got seen or not, honestly. So I think there's a guy in that building that can see you. I know I need to get on that dumpster and jump up there to get into the building. So I'm just waiting for the coast to be clear there. And then I'll probably shoot that light out from here, because it'll alert them. And that way, if they do go and check it out, I'll be clear at least. Alternatively, I drop on this dude right now. Screw it. Okay. That didn't go to plan. I don't know how he didn't see me. When I'm just like hanging in front of his face. But there you go. Okay, so you see there. Like one of our associates. Cherkezi, I want you and your men to check it out. I think what that does is spawns extra guards, because it was a civilian in this house that saw that happen. But I didn't actually get caught by a guard or anything. So again, I'm just going to keep moving. There was that guy there in that flipping building. Now, I could have shot the lights out and stuff, but I just wanted to drop on that dude. So, it is what it is, man. Okay, we've got the code for this. This is the police basement. I think it was 5929, wasn't it? Yep. Okay, and we're in. Now I'm gonna follow this guy.
Who the hell are you supposed to be?
They're just drunk prisoners, don't worry about them.
Is there anybody else seeing a bionic commando?
Let him go in. There. Hit the lights there. Now he's gonna go check out that light switch. Bonk him on his head. Get the light back off. Keeps the body hidden. I'll drop him in this corner. And I might as well use this computer while I'm here, see if I get anything. Got a data stick. With nothing really important on it. If there was something important, it'd go into my notes, like a door code or something. Now, I do know that there's a guy through there in that window. It's just a civilian. But I would rather he didn't see me. I wonder if that is... Is this glass? Oh, this window's open.
How did that happen?
I think I should be able to wait here for this dude. I'm not sure if he's gonna come and check it out.
Who did that?
He is. No, he might come and check this light switch. He is. And I can grab him.
One false move and you're dead. I need information.
Okay.
I'm looking for two Americans. Probably dead.
Gringo will kill me.
Where are they?
Nearby. The morgue. They're dead. I helped the mortician find the microchips under their scalps.
Subdermals.
Yeah. Please don't hurt me. Please don't hurt me.
All right. Obviously, he's a civilian. I'm not going to kill him. Just knock him out in this corner. Slap the lights back off again. Okay, now I've got to be careful because we're in a police station. I'm fairly sure there's going to be cameras somewhere, right? What's in here? That door's locked. Well, we're here, right? So let's figure out what the heck is in here. At what? I know I'm looking for the bodies. In the morgue. Pretty sure this is not the place to go, but... Oh, shite. I was not expecting a guard to be in there. Tell you what I should have done. I should have used the snake arm on that. That was almost detrimental. Good job that I had the lights out in this corridor, because he would have just straight up seen me and shot me. I'll hide him in here where it's dark. And now we'll go and see if there is actually anything in this room now that it is clear. And that's been my lesson, to get into the habit of using the snake cams. See, there's absolutely no reason to come in here. Only to get yourself caught being a curious cat. So we move. I think this is just the room where... I'm just checking up the cameras, that's why I'm going really slow. Oh, I think the morgue's back here. So this is where we need to be. Nothing. No, I don't know if there's a scientist in here. It looks empty. Okay, shit, we've got a camera though. That's the end of that. We've got a med kit.
I've got agents Blaustein and Madison.
Rest in peace. Somebody cut out their subdermals.
Where do we go from here?
We follow the subdermals if we can.
There's a security camera here.
Good thinking. We'll track the subdermals from the video archives. The station's surveillance room is on the top floor.
Sounds like we're going up, boys. Come on. Okay. Now, how sneaky have I got to be here? Don't know. Don't really remember. We got to check his checkpoint confidence. Okay, we're just going to swing straight in it. Oh, I remember this room. So where we want to get is over the other side of this room. I believe I can sneak straight along this wall.
I'd like to talk to your superior.
There's quite a funny little exchange
by fetching your
that happens
superior.
Here.
I'm all that is. How can I help you?
I'd like to register.
I don't really have time to watch it.
Then you'll have to ask at the desk to your right.
Very well.
And it goes to the desk to the right, and it's the same guard.
May I help you?
You're the same
that
cop.
Yes.
Door is where I'm trying
to
get.
Public relations desk.
Fine. I would like to register a complaint.
Of course, sir. If you could just have a seat until somebody's ready to help you.
You've got to be kidding me.
I could easily have you arrested, sir.
We gotta check his ear. Wrong one. Okay, I'm fairly sure from memory of this room that it's this far door. There's a computer, you can get a data stick in this room. But there's nothing on it. But I might as well grab it, just for the sake of it. Because I know this room's empty, it's fine. Now, if you want to take those guys out in that main room, you can turn the light off in this room. Then open the door, and they'll notice that the light's off and come in, because they'll be like, what the hell? And then you can take them out when they investigate the light. You can also just take them out from their seats. And the other one won't notice. Like, I could grab this guy now and knock him out in that little dark patch. But I think the way I want to go is in here. Oh, there's a dude just through there. I can see his shadow, but I'm not sure what way he's facing. Okay, he's facing the other way. Come on, interrogate him. So we'll knock him out in his corner. And then we shall use the computer.
Great work, Fisher. Drop them. We're scanning the videotapes now.
There, that's our guy. We got him red-handed.
Can you run his face through Echelon?
Already on it. Hey, check it out. A license plate. 84KP214.
Fantastic.
No. Fisher, we got what we need.
That's an interrogation room. Don't need to go in there. That room has got some ammo in it, if you want to pick up some ammo, but I don't need to. I'm not really shooting anyone. So as long as you're nice and slow, you can just creep back downstairs. And avoid those guys in that room altogether, and they've got no idea what has happened there. Now, I'm going to flick this on because I know... from last time that this dude did it. No, I would say hug the wall here. So this is where that interaction was earlier. Hug the wall into this spot, and then I'm gonna hug the wall. Okay, I can't, that's anyway, so just try your best to stick as close to the side of this as possible. Open that. There's your ride. And we're away. Right, that's the first mission of the original Splinter Cell done. It wasn't ghosted, I think I got caught. I think I got shot once, right? Something. Yeah, stay tuned for mission 2. And we'll just keep plugging away at this game. Hopefully you enjoy the series. If you've never played Splinter Cell before, that's crazy. But if you haven't, it's all going to be here for you to enjoy. Thanks for watching. Matta ne.
Raimei to tomo ni shire. Shidari!